Is 5G safe? Let's find out. First article, 5G confirmed safe by radiation watchdogs. 5G is safe. Oh, thank goodness. Thank God. Oh, hang on. We have no reason to believe 5G is safe. Okay, guys, so the internet is a mess and it's all over the place when it comes to the safety of 5G. In this video, we will take a look at the dangers of the 5G networks, but also how China is gaining influence all across Europe, country after country, with their 5G network technology. Let's begin! Let's be clear from the start. The safety of 5G network is inconclusive, and anyone saying otherwise are not being real with you. This article from TheGuardian.com reads, "No scientific evidence that technology possess threat to human health." It goes on to read, "The guidelines have been developed after a thorough review of all relevant scientific literature, scientific workshops, and an extensive public consultation process. They provided protection against all scientifically substantiated adverse health effects due to electromagnetic field exposure in the 100 kilohertz to 300 gigahertz range." So the problem with this is that the new 5G networks can emit exposure of up to 500 or 600 gigahertz within that range, and that's far above what they considered in the 1990s. And that's actually what they say later on in this article. But millimeter wave 5G and other broadcast connections above the 6 gigahertz band were not anticipated in 1998. This article from Nature.com describes the 5G networks in a little more of a skeptical light. It reads, "We believe that the main biological effect of the electromagnetic radiation from mobile phones is a rise in temperature," Wood explains. "There are also concerns that there could be more subtle effects, such as links between long-term exposure and certain types of cancer. But while there is some evidence from epidemiological and animal studies, these remain controversial." I mean, sometimes they just come up with words to sound impressive. The main issue here is how 5G affects living tissue on humans and animals alike. And it seems that humans can have their cells affected in such a way that it increases body temperature. Before we move on to China's influence with 5G, let's finish off this topic with this article from Scientific American. It reads, "Numerous recent scientific publications have shown that EMF affects living organisms at levels well below most international and national guidelines. Effects include increased cancer risk, cellular stress, increase in harm-free radicals, genetic damages, structural and functional changes of the reproductive system, learning and memory deficits, neurological disorders, and negative impacts on general well-being in humans. Damage goes well beyond the human race, as there is growing evidence of harmful effects to both plant and animal life." Later on, it reads, "The WHO, International Agency for Research on Cancer, classified RFR as possibly carcinogenic to humans." I'm probably murdering that word. In 2011. Last year, a $30 million study conducted by the US National Toxicology Program, NTP, found clear evidence that 2 years of exposure to cell phone RFR increased cancer in male rats and damaged DNA in rats and mice of both sexes. Now, this is in 2011, and back then they were operating on 3G and then later on 4G. When we're talking about 5G, we're talking about a radiation that is just around 50 times more powerful, operating at a whole other level. So to me, the conclusion is clear. We don't know how much we're gonna be affected by 5G, but we are not unaffected by it. This makes me really happy that some countries are not just instantly getting it, but some countries have actually banned the practice of 5G because they recognize the possible health ramifications 5G can bring. By the way, guys, this is a new channel, so if you like the content that I'm creating, please consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps me out a lot. Thank you. So I wanted to wrap up this video with how China is gaining influence through their 5G network all across Europe. And this article from foreignpolicy.com outlines what I mean very well. It reads, "The security risks inherent in Chinese-made 5G networking equipment are easy to understand, because the companies that make the equipment are subservient to the Chinese government, they could be forced to include backdoors in the hardware or software to give Beijing remote access. Eavesdropping is also a risk, although efforts to listen in would almost certainly be detectable. More insidious is the possibility that Beijing could use its access to degrade or disrupt communications services in the event of a larger geopolitical conflict. Since the internet, especially the Internet of Things, is expected to rely heavily on 5G infrastructure, potential Chinese infiltration is a serious national security threat." You see, right now, China is using the coronavirus pandemic to install cameras outside of people's homes. This is an actual thing. In some cases, even inside also. It contributes to their surveillance society, which is all beginning to run on the 5G network. This is the same Chinese network that countries in Europe is now beginning to gradually implement. And as we do, as the article said, it's not difficult to see China getting a foothold inside Europe they couldn't have dreamt of around 15 to 20 years ago. Oh, and look, UK will allow Huawei to supply 5G with tight restrictions. With tight restrictions. Oh, we're so dumb. Okay, guys, so what do you think? Is this an overreaction? Should we just get the Chinese-run 5G network little by little and at least get all the benefits from it? Let me know what you think in the comment section below, and I'll make sure to answer you. Thank you for watching and have a great day.